Friday Night Lights are upon us, next on Conversations. Hello and welcome to the special edition of Conversations. I'm Jeannie Curtis. AISD TV sports announcer John Nelson recently sat down and talked with the high school football varsity head coaches about their upcoming 2012 season.
All right, Jeannie, thanks very much. We begin with head coach Bob Wager in his seventh year at Arlington Martin, a regional finalist last year. The Warriors were 12-2, and coach, obviously the carryover effect, you're ranked in the top 10 again this year. It's pretty good at Martin High School right now.
We're extremely excited, John, and I think the one thing that you look at and the thing that I'm most excited now going into my seventh year is that every group of players that have come through have accepted the responsibility of taking the program to the next level. And we have every confidence that this year's senior class will do the same thing.
There's nothing like December football when maybe the whole game hinges on one play, but that's where you want to be in December.
Well, there's nothing better to do in the month of December. And when you're still playing football and you look around and you get to the point where there's only eight teams left or four teams left, that not only creates a great excitement within your football team and your entire football program, it creates an excitement for your community and an entire city. And we got a chance to taste that last year, and we liked it so much we'd really like to try to do it again.
Coach, why should people get excited about Kyle Hicks and your outstanding kicker, Mr. Grogan, who was All-State last year?
We do have two luxuries. One, I think Kyle Hicks is one of the great backs in the country. He's already committed to the University of Texas. And to know Kyle Hicks, all of the things that he does on the football field, he's a wow factor, but he also has a phenomenal work ethic, and he's just genuinely a wonderful young man, and that makes it fun to coach. From Ben Grogan's standpoint, first team All-State kicker, many high school teams do not have that type of a weapon, and when you can play well in the kicking game and especially have every confidence that one player is as clutch as any on your team, those are two great cornerstones going into a football season.
Where is your strength this year? Are you pretty well balanced? Because I know that your special teams have always been well coached. You like special teams play. Defense has always been solid. But what about heading into this year?
I think the biggest thing is the strength comes in our expectations and the investment that we've made from the end of last season until this season. When you can go into a football season and, we're talking about public high schools. You get what you get. We get the students that live on the southwest side of Arlington. You have to hang your hat on something. And I think if you can hang your hat on the work ethic and the investment that's being made and then also look back at the tradition that's been built, our optimism comes in high expectations and ridiculous work ethic.
Where is your team motto this year, or do you have a team slogan at Martin?
No, we don't have an annual tradition. I think again, you go back to saying we're excited about being ranked in the top 10 in the state, but it means very little at the start of the season. Means a whole lot at the end of the year. But that top 10 ranking in the state, that doesn't have anything to do with the football team that we have right now. I think that has to do with football teams that we've had in years past. That's the expectation that's been set by the players that have come before our 2012 team, and our players understand that, and they understand that there's a responsibility that comes with wearing black and silver now, and that expectation is to play like your hair's on fire, make a total commitment, and carry the torch for the next group of Warriors.
Finally, Coach, your non-district schedule this year.
Well, we get an opportunity to open at Allen in a scrimmage, and we'll open up a $65 million stadium, and so we're extremely excited about that. And then we're at home against DeSoto, who according to Dave Campbell's football magazine is ranked number 8 in the state, and so that's a ranking that's ahead of us, so we're excited about that opportunity. And then we go to Dallas Skyline, who's the number 1 ranked team in the state, and so really in a 7-day period of time we get an opportunity to go toe-to-toe with two of the top ranked teams in the state. And in Skyline's national ranking, you know, one of the top teams in the country. And so great opportunity in front of us, and we're really looking forward to it.
Coach, it's right around the corner. Good luck to you and the Martin Warriors this year.
Thank you, John. Always a pleasure to be here.
Well, head coach Scott Peachin, year number 10, guiding the Arlington Colts. And Scott, a lot of exciting things happening over the summer in Colt country.
Well, without a doubt, you know, we are very, very excited about having UTA back, without a question. It was a big deal having to travel over and play at Cravens Field. And so there was a lot of people that stepped up, O.J. Kemp and Jennifer Young, in getting that done in our community. But having a chance to get back to our home field, that was our home field for 26 years, is a big deal.
Tell me about the kids that took part in the 7-on-7 tournament.
Well, we did really well all summer long. Our kids were extremely committed. Not only did they do 7-on-7 and big man state challenges, but they also worked out hard in the mornings. But we did well. We went down the state tournament. We didn't play great on Friday, but we came back and got to the final four of the consolation bracket on Saturday and did well. And then our big boys won their fifth straight big man state title this summer. And so very, very proud of our kids. And the biggest thing is they learn how to compete during the summertime.
Coach, a lot of the high schools now getting field turf on the practice fields. How does that enhance your overall program?
Well, it's incredible. It's something that over the past 10 years that I've been fighting for in the city of Arlington. A few times I've been put on a gag order that unless I was willing to put front the money, I needed to stop talking about it. But it's amazing. And I think that, first of all, from a football standpoint, all of those days when you have bad weather days, nowhere to practice, having the opportunity to work with hashes and numbers that you don't get a chance to do on grass fields. But then on top of that, just looking at all of our football programs being able to play on it, including our junior highs are going to come up this year that feed into Arlington High and get to play their game some on it. Our soccer programs, by the time you get to grass in January and February, it's dirt. And so for them to have a chance to play on it, you know, from our band to our drill team, all of those people in our schools benefit from having the field turf. And it looks amazing. You know, it couldn't be more proud of. We obviously added a cafeteria and some science classrooms at Arlington High. We changed the face of it, got a marquee, got the new field turf. And a school back in 1955 that so many people are so proud of looks amazing right now. We're really proud of it.
Coach Sammy Douglas getting a lot of attention, and deservedly so. Talk about him, and you have a quarterback this year in Connor Huffman.
Well, starting with Sammy, he's the leader of our defense. We have one other kid named Devin Harris that really runs the ship for us. But Sammy Douglas is a three-year starter for us, playing middle linebacker, and he makes all the plays on the field, so we're going to put him in a position to do that. But on top of that, he's the hardest worker we have in our program. And when you have good football players or great football players like Sammy, that is also the kids that work the hardest and are good leaders, your football team is going to be successful, and he's that kid for us. You know, committed to TCU, and we talk about TCU Horned Frog football, but at the end of the day, for him, it's all about Arlington High School. It's all about this season and our football team. Connor Huffman is one of the smartest kids in the school. He's 18th in his class out of 600 kids, and for us, our quarterback really, with what we do now, has got to be a smart kid and make a lot of decisions in our passing game and run game, and he does all that. And he's a type of kid that you tell him once, and it's done, and you don't have to keep repeating over and over again how to get something right. He's a great competitor. You know, he's not very tall, and so you have to have that mentality that I'm going to compete every snap and I'm going to outdo you, and he's that type of kid. And, you know, he's a winner, too. You know, he's had a lot of success through his career. He's waited, sitting behind Josh last year, Josh Greer, for a chance to play, and he's getting that opportunity. I think as a senior, he's going to make the most of it.
Finally, Coach, very tough non-district schedule this year.
Yes, sir. What you find out is when you play good football year in and year out, a lot of people don't want to play you. And so you've got to go out and play good people. And for us, that's really been our philosophy. You know, we play a Marcus team week one that went 10-2 last year under Brian Irwin. And his son's a quarterback. Another son's a receiver. They're going to pound you, and they're really well coached. So that's going to be a good challenge for us. We turn around after that and get Mansfield Timberview, who last year went to the state semifinals. We knew early in the season just how good Timberview was when we got to play them last year, and they've got a lot of those athletes back. And then we get to play Louisville. I've got a man that I've known for a while coming from Katy that's the defense coordinator named Greg Miller. He's going to do a great job there. But we put that game together week three. And so we'll find out pretty quickly, you know, what kind of team we're going to have playing that good competition.
Scott, appreciate it. Good luck to the Colts.
Thanks, John.
Carlos Lynn in year number five guiding the Seguin Cougars. Seguin last year 4-6. Coach, you did finish strong. You won two of your last three games last year. So can you feel a carryover effect even though it's been a season ago?
Absolutely. You know, we feel like we did make a late season surge right there at the end, and we got a lot of kids that are coming back. So we feel real confident that we can take that momentum on into this season.
Talk about your team slogan, your team motto for 2012.
Well, this year we're going with this. It's the theme, the slogan is probably older than I am. It's MTXE, which stands for mental toughness and extra effort. And we really believe that, you know, there are some games that we should win on our discipline, being mentally tough, being focused, being strong on that side, and then just busting our butt all the time, giving a great effort every single play. So we feel like if we can do those two things, we're going to be successful.
The realignment, you lost some teams, you added some teams, the district a little bit different makeup this year.
Absolutely. Each week there's a challenge. The coaches that we're going in with, they called it last year the little SEC. You know, so we're, you know, Waxahachie, Lancaster, Ennis, those teams are, you know, year in and year out, always good. They have outstanding programs.
Jordan Hicks, outstanding all-around player, and your quarterback, Kelton Moore. I know we expect big things out of him. He can run and throw.
Absolutely, absolutely. He's one of those kids that you love to have a quarterback with his demeanor. He's very, very, you know, under control. He has everything pretty much, you know, the kids, they feed off of him, and he don't get anything out of sorts, and he's just an excellent example of what we need at quarterback. Nothing rattles him. Jordan Hicks is going to provide us some great senior leadership. You know, he was a first-team all-district guy last year. He was a part of the school record 4x100 relay team. He ran second leg on that, one of our fast kids. He's a 4'3 kid and just a phenomenal athlete.
Carlos, how important is it for you to get off to a good district start with some of the new teams this year?
You know, we have, the way our schedule is set, all of pretty much the heavy hitters up front. We open up with Ennis, Mansfield Summit, Lancaster, and Waxahachie right off the bat. So our mettle is going to be tested very, very early, and it's important to get a good start. We're going to know where we stand pretty quick.
Coach, it should be exciting. Good luck to you and the Seguin Cougars.
Absolutely. Thank you so much.
The Lamar Vikings last year finished 6-5. Head coach Trent Fuller's in year number three. And, Coach, I know we're excited about the upcoming season. You have some quarterback competition issues, but all that should be resolved. I guess it's a matter of just learning the playbook because I know you like to throw the football.
Well, I do, but at the same time, you know, we've got to do whatever fits our kids the best. And, you know, we do have we have some good receivers, but we have some really good running backs we want to try to highlight too. I really don't care much about how we get it done, just as long as we can find the best way for our kids to get it done.
Talk about your receivers, Daquan and Merriweather.
Mayweather, yeah. Yes. Yeah. You know, great kids, hard workers, very talented, they're just fun to be around, and excited to have them back for a second year. They were our two top receivers last year, and they're both back, so we're definitely feel good in that area.
You qualified again this year for the 7-on-7. What was that experience like another year?
Well, you know, it's getting more and more competitive every year. We didn't do great at the 7-on-7 tournament, but you've got to keep in mind that everybody there just to get there has either won or gotten second place in a tournament. So we didn't have the best showing, but had a lot of transition, you know, with a new 7-on-7 coach, and, you know, a lot of different things that some some out of our control, but that the kids dealt with. But you know, overall, I've always told the kids that as long as it makes us better for 11-on-11, then it's worth it. You know, mm-hmm. whether it's something you learn how to handle a game time situation, or how to be a leader, how to win, how to lose. You know, if it's something that's going to help us during the season, I feel like 7-on-7 has been a success for us.
Coach, how soon will you be able to know that these kids should be doing what they were supposed to be doing over the summer?
Oh, it won't take long. probably that first day, you'll have a very good idea who did what they were supposed to. You know, some of them, come up and work at the school, so we see them, you know, and then others, you know, have jobs and stuff like that, so they may do it on their own, but we'll find out. It won't take long.
How do you combat the heat? A lot of coaches have different ways of going about things, but summer is summer in Texas, and Yes. There are, I guess, no shortcuts.
Right. We're going really early this year for a couple reasons. One, you know, we don't have to worry about the heat because it's 6 o'clock in the morning and it's not going to be, you know, you're not going to have to be taken off the field. The other reason, we've got a few new coaches this year that have required training throughout the district and stuff. So really early is the time where there's no conflicts with other meetings, or there's no conflicts with the heat. So that's the best way we're doing it this year. And of course, you know, the mind frame's changed a little bit. You know, used to be, you know, water was a sign of weakness almost, you know, mm-hmm. And now it's, you know, everybody understands that that's what you need, and get as much of it as you can, and plenty of breaks and things like that. So,
all right, who do the Vikings play in non-district?
We start off with South Grand Prairie, and then we have our homecoming against Irving Nimitz, and then Keller Central at Keller.
All right, Trent, good luck to you and the Lamar all Vikings.
Right. Thank you very much.
Head coach Kenny Perry in year number 7, guiding the Bowie Volunteers. The Vols last year, 9-4, made a run in the playoffs. 9 returning starters for you, Kenny. I know you have to feel good about this year.
You know what? This group of kids is a very special group. Probably the smartest team I've ever had. So it's going to, you know, we've always had some good athletes. We've had some good kids, but this group combines the brains and some athleticism. So it'll be pretty exciting to see what they do.
I know it's hard to replace Colby Listonby and Russell Hansborough, but you feel that some of the kids are getting a little closer, are they not?
Oh, yeah. Our kids, like I said, we've got a lot of pieces that, you know, we need to be successful. A lineman, we finally got, you know, a great offensive lineman in Chris Thigpen. We got returning center and Stephen Young. We've got some lineman pieces that, you know, we've never had before. So I'm pretty excited about what we got up front. But receiver-wise, you know, we're going to be just as good. You know, we pride ourselves on playing defense. And so I feel good about what this team has.
Kenny, the loss to South Lake Carroll last year, how hungry were the kids immediately right after that game and throughout the whole summer?
You know, we've I think our coaches, we've always played South Lake pretty good from when I was at Sam and we're here, you know, our kids, this is a different group. These kids are hungry, and you know, they know that what we have to do to stay on top. And, you know, I think our program's one of the best programs around the area. So we're going to keep doing the things that we've done to get us up there. And, you know, that loss still kind of burns because, you know, we had a lead going in, and you don't like giving up a lead. But I think we learned some as coaches and as players from that game that we'll take into this year. But, you know, our kids are going to be ready to play.
All right, talk about Bowie's non-conference schedule.
Well, like I said, I think we're playing three teams in the top 25, being, you know, Mansfield. They've got, I think, 17 returning starters from a 4-deep team. Mesquite has got, I think, 18 returning starters from a 4-deep team. And then, of course, Skyline, I think, is number 1 or 2. So we're definitely going to get challenged, but, you know, that doesn't bother me. If you want to win state championship, you got to play good people. And, you know, I've always believed that. And, you know, regardless if we're 3-0 or 0-3, we're going to know what we're going to have to do going into district, because our district's, you know, like I said, it's a tough road. So you got to be ready to play.
Kenny, for the Bowie Volunteers, you're at Wildman Field, and that's so much easier come game day because the trip really, really helps, doesn't it?
Oh, it's you know, at first I kind of worried about it, but it's 5 minutes away. You know, it changes a lot of things for you as a coach and your kids and your fans. I mean, it's easy to get to. So it's been good for us. And, you know, I loved playing there when I was at Sam. I mean, that's kind of like going home for me a little bit. And great stadium, holds our fans. And, you know, our kids, I think they like playing it as well.
You're getting field turf as well as the other schools. It's long needed. It's surely going to help in the course of a long run.
No doubt. I mean, I think there's just as far as games, not only just football, but soccer, just canceling games. It's going to be great for us. I think, you know, I've always said it. I'm an Arlington guy. I think our community, our school board, definitely our school district is seeing we've got to catch up with everybody else. You know, facility-wise, we're 15 years behind. Our kids deserve the same thing that the Texas Rangers and Dallas Cowboys get. And you know what, as a coach, I think all these coaches and Coach Kemp, we're going to fight for that for our kids because they deserve it. You know, the same thing that our pro athletes get, these kids that are in our school system, you know, for 12 and 13 years, they deserve the same thing.
I know the volunteer students and the alumni are excited, Kenny. It's almost here, and I know you're just itching to get started.
Oh, I can't wait. You know, our community has been great. You know, their football, it's a big football community now, you know, and I think they relish football season. I know our students and our administration is, and I know I am. I'm excited about this year like I am every year, but I think we got a chance to put another pretty good product on the field.
All right, Kenny, good luck to the Vols.
Thanks, John. Appreciate it.
Well, the Sam Houston Texans about ready to get it started. Anthony Chris in year number two. And, Coach, what's different about the second year? I'm sure things have fallen into place maybe a little easier than at this point last season.
Yeah, last year, you know, it was hustle and bustle. This year, a little more organization on our part. You know, things, I know the kids, my coaching staff is settled, so it's more kind of, you want to say, back to the normal routine.
All right, you've got some returning starters I know you're excited about. Talk about what you have on both sides of the ball and Brian Pruitt also.
Okay, what we have is we have a lot of returning starters because, you know, I had 30 sophomores on varsity last year. I just basically took any sophomore that could play and put them on varsity. So now we have 7 returning starters on offense and 8 returning starters on defense. But more importantly, we have 13 kids with experience coming back on offense and 16 kids with experience coming back on defense that actually played. So Byron Pruitt is going to anchor our defense. He's 6 foot, 290-pound defensive tackle. Led our team in tackles last year. Him along with Rashad Burton, fantastic junior safety is coming up. So our defense have gotten a lot of experience. On the offensive side of the ball, we're going to start Irvin Hill, our quarterback. He's a sophomore. And so kind of reminds me of the Sherrod Harris days. Going to take the sophomore, let him give him the keys, let him drive the bus, along with Andrew Alvarado as our tailback. So we got a senior tailback. He's going to lead that offense. And hopefully we'll score some points this year, and hopefully we'll stop some people this year.
Yeah. Now, the seniors you have, Coach, you're going to have senior leadership, no question about it.
Right. So we have about a small class.
Yeah.
It's only about 8 seniors we have. But Byron Pruitt is going to lead that class. You know, him and his twin brother, Myron Pruitt, have twins. Myron plays right tackle for us, and Brian plays defensive tackle. And then we have George Luke, who's going to be our wide receiver. And basically, Chantless Roberts is going to anchor the secondary. So our senior class, it's a small class, but it's an experienced class. So we'll get good senior leadership out of those guys. We'll have 3 starters on defense, and I believe 4 starters on offense that are seniors.
I've asked some of the coaches how they combat or put up with the summer heat. You've been around long enough. There are no shortcuts, but how do you combat the heat?
I practice at night, so I don't have to worry about the sun. You know, I think the only way you can deal with it now because, you know, back when I was growing up, no such thing as an ozone.
Right.
You know, it was just hot, but, you know, you could go out. We have so much cement now in the city, and so basically what we try to do is to practice at night when we can. Then when the school year starts, you know, water, take quite a few breaks to make sure we give our kids a break, take the helmet off and take the shoulder pads off as much as we can to make sure we combat the heat because it's a serious issue and you have to take it seriously, so you can't take it lightly. So that's what we try to do at Sam Houston is to take as many breaks as we can and try to stay cool as we can, keep them hydrated. But there's no answer for this Texas heat.
No, there isn't. Kids excited about the new field turf and everything that's happening at Sam?
Well, they're very excited. We're not getting new field turf at Sam. We already have field turf. So the other 4 high schools have it. But Wildman and Cravens You know, we still, we're at the Headfield turf, so the other four high schools are getting, they're not excited because we're not getting a new one. But I think it's going to be great for our district to be able to go to every school now, whether it rains or whatever.
Yeah, but you can already see the effects since it was put in and how that really helps.
It helps a lot because, you know, now rain doesn't really affect you anymore. In the good old days, you know, if it rained, oh, we're going to go out, we're going to tear up the field. But now it's good, save, cuts down on injuries. So, you know, it's an exciting time at the AISD.
I know how one of the non-district games came about, but talk about your other non-district games.
You're speaking about the O.D. Wyatt game. We're going to play my brother. That's going to be a huge, a great night for the Chris family. We're calling it the Chris Extravaganza. You know, not the Chris Bowl, not the Chris Classic, but the Chris Extravaganza. So that's going to be good when I play my brother, my son, my nephew, and my dad. They're all at O.D. Wyatt High School. Then I'm also playing North Mesquite. Coach Robinson is a good friend of mine. We decided to play. And then we're going to bring back the battle at Wildman with Coach Lynn. So we're going to play the Seguin Cougars. So we talked about all these classics. I'm getting involved in classics and extravaganza and bowls. So the battle at Wildman is going to be a great deal, too, with play Seguin High School.
Anthony, should be exciting. Good luck to you and the Sam Houston Texans.
Thank you.
All right, Jeannie, back to you.
Thanks, John, and good luck to all of our AISD high school athletes. Go out and cheer on for your favorite team. For John Nelson, I'm Jeannie Curtis. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you again here on Conversations.